Good morning, students. So in the last video, we have seen up to how to open office calc and how to enter values in it. And you know what do you mean by a column, what do you mean by a row, and what is a cell, and which one is the home cell. So A1 is the home cell, and how you can cut, copy, and paste the values inside a cell. So up to this, we have learned. And the last video, so you know to save, you know to open, and you know to close the existing file also. So you know what is the extension for the calc. So now we are going to see autofill feature. Okay, so next we are going to see autofill feature. So what do you mean by autofill? So if you want to type a serial number, or if you want to type any numbers from 1 to 100 or 1 to 50, so you no need to type 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, etc. You no need to go on typing each and every number. So there is an option in OpenOffice Calc that autofill features. So with the help of that, if you can type only the starting value, and if you drag that, automatically the numbers will be listed in your corresponding cell. Okay. So let us see. You have learned how to copy and paste a formula from one cell to other cells in the previous section. The process of copy and paste can be replaced by a click and drag. Okay, so click and drag, and it is called as autofill. This is an alternate way to copy and paste. So autofill feature fills the content of one cell to all the dragged cells. The content may be a data or formula. So when in the last video, when we try to copy a formula of one cell to another cell, the cell name automatically get changed, isn't it? The same way, if you fill a relative formula, all the address of filled formula will be changed. So that we have seen in the last video. So similarly, what will happen? See, so when you select a cell, you know how the cell will look. Just it will be covered with the corners. But if you press at this corner, last corner, okay, that is called a drag fill handle. In the down right corner, there will be a square like shape. So that is called a drag fill handle. So if you click that, and if you drag, the numbers will be displayed. Okay, so this is, see here. So this is the drag fill handle. So you, if you, how many, up to how many cells you want the autofill, you can click and drag. Okay, so cell pointers, drag fill handle is used to autofill. Just click and drag this handle to fill the contents. It can be dragged towards right or down. Same can be achieved by using the menu options. In menu, you have to go to edit, fill, down, or edit, fill, right. Okay, so these two you can do it. Whether you can do it in the right side or you can do it in the downwards. So what is autofill series? So next we are going to see autofill series. So before going to autofill series, let me explain this in OpenOffice Calc. Okay, so for that, you have to go to the OpenOffice. So if you click that, you will be having your, and that you have to go to the spreadsheet. So I double click. So you have got your new OpenOffice page, is it now? So can you see this? This is untitled one. So untitled one. So this is at this time, it is in the F12 cell, okay. So, if you want to drag, suppose I want to have a serial number. I am having the heading as serial number, okay. So, and if I want to move here. See, I am having the hashtag serial number. And if I want to, from here I want 1. And next I want 2. Like this, I want to have my serial number up to 10. Then if I click this, see, at this here. You can see that this is called as the drag fill handle. Okay, this is a, so if I click this, at this corner you will be having this. So this is called as the drag fill handle. So when I move my cursor to near this corner, you can see it changes to plus sign. It will change to plus sign. So now I have clicked. Now I am dragging. See, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let me have up to 8. Can you see the numbers? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So once you type the number, and if you have, this is when your cursor, when you move here, it will move to the plus sign. And if you click and if you drag this, so here there is no number, so I have not received any number. So if you, like this, if you want to have 101. I have, let me select this cell, and if now this is changed to plus sign, now I am clicking and then now I am drag. I am click and I am dragging. See, let I will be having up to 108. So whatever you are going to have your number, if you at the right down corner, there will be a plus sign. If you move your cursor, it will change to plus sign, and if you click that and drag up to how many cells you want, you will get the numbers correspondingly. Okay, so this is called the auto fill. Okay, so how, like this only we are getting our number, right? So this is our drag fill handle. So when you move my cursor, it will change to plus sign and will have. The same thing can be performed using, so suppose I am having here 1001. Not only 1001, I can have 201 also. Okay, so you can go to using menu also, you can do this. So you have to go to edit menu and then you will be having a fill option. So you have to go to down or you can go to right like this. So first I have to select this cell and I go to edit menu and there is a fill option. So if I get down and right, okay. Why it is not highlighted? Okay, let us see. So it's the same thing can be done using edit, fill and down. Okay, so if I select this cell, so see, if I go to the edit menu, you can see the fill option, it will automatically in the down. Okay, so similarly we can do it in right also, as we have said earlier. So suppose I'm having here and 101, and if I want to move here, I can select this cell. And then if I drag rightwards, like this also, I can have my autofill. So whether I can have it down or I can have it right, okay. So using edit menu also, so if I go and see here fill, it will be in the right side, okay. So similarly, in which way we want, you can fill it. So next we will see the autofill series, okay. So this is the autofill feature. So first we have seen how to do it using drag and click and drag. Now we will see autofill series. So autofill is also used to generate a series of values. Series of value means here we are having the corresponding values. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. That is the next value only we are having. Okay, the next, immediately we are having the next value. So if you want to have any series, so 2, 4, 6, that is an even series. 1, 3, 5, that is an odd series. So suppose you want to have the values like that, then you can use this autofill series. So also it's generated a series of values. So if you want to generate 1, 2, 3 up to some length, it can be done by a simple click and dragging over. Generally whole number series. So that one we have seen. So in cell A1, type as 1 and press enter. Click A1 to place the cell pointer. Click drag fill handle of cell pointer. Now the mouse pointer becomes small plus. Drag over the cells while dragging. The generated value will be this only I have shown you up to this. So release the mouse pointer, selected cells will be filled with series of value. So this is the for automatic numbers, so this you know. So next, using command how we can generate series. Okay, so for that you have to go to edit menu, fill series. Command is used to generate different set of series. Before using this series, a set of cells should be selected. So before going to this, you have to select the set of cells. Using fill series feature, you can fill series of values at any direction, okay. That autofill only fills either right or down, okay. So direction down, right, up, left, selected cell direction will be default. So series type, linear, so there are many series type. First one linear, that is to generate a sequence of series, that is like even series 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Growth, to generate multiplication series like squares of number 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. This is the multiplication series. Okay. To generate data series, when you select date as series type, time unit section, that is from this date to this date, how many date, like that. And next comes autofill. To generate a continuous series of values, when you select autofill, time unit section, end value and increment text box become disabled. When you select autofill, select pantingna, these values will be disabled. Okay, so now let us see how it gets. So time unit, enable only when you select the series type as date. So there are many series type, that is linear, growth, date and autofill. So if you select autofill, these options get disabled. So only for date, the time unit is enabled. Okay, so day, week, day, month, year. So day means to generate date series, that is day wise. Week day means to generate date series week date wise. Month means month wise and year means year wise. So start value. What is the start value? Initial value of the series should be type. And what is the end value? End value of the series should be type. So if you fail to specify the end value, series will be generated up to the selected cells. So before applying this, you have to select a particular cells, is it no? So up to the selected cells, the series will be generated. So if you go to the edit menu and if you click fill and if you go to series, this dialog box will appear. So in that, see the direction you are having down, right, up, left, and series type you are having linear, growth, date, autofill, and if you have date only, you have this time unit, that is day wise, weekly, month and year will be enabled. So if you click date only, this option will be enabled. And next we are having start value, end value and increment. Okay. So if you know the start value and the end value. So if your selection is less than specified end value, series will be generated only up to the selected cells, that you know. So what do you mean by this increment? So increment, it is a middle value between the first value and the second value of series. So the next value, third value of the series will be generated based on this value. Okay. So if you want to generate a decreasing order, then negative value should be specified in the increment. Clear? So let us have, so see they have given self practice. So if you want to generate even number series from 2 to 20, you can, how we will perform? Generate a series 5, 10, 15, 20 up to selected cells. So, and if you want to generate a series of 2, 4, 8, 16 up to this, how we can perform? Okay. So they have also assumed today is Friday and generate next 25 Fridays. So like this also you can, so for this you have to go to the date and you have to click weekdays. Similarly, you can perform this anything. So for your self practice, they have given all this. Okay. So now let us see in OpenOffice how it will happen. Let me go to a new one, new spreadsheet. So this is the one I'm having. Okay. So if I want to give, I have to select the cells first. So let me select some cells. So I have selected the cells. Now I'm moving to edit. And I'm going to fill, there is an option called series. So if I click this, I will get my fill series dialog box. This is the fill series dialog box. So see, down, so as I have selected cells in the vertical, I'm having only two options enabled, down and up. So series type, I can take any series type. Let me show you the linear. So linear means, so it will be going on the direction. Okay, so start value. So let me give 2. And for end value, so I can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so up to I am having 8. Okay, so let me have my end value as 16. Increment, so by default it is 1. Suppose I want to have even number, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, like this. So I am giving increment by 2. So if I give OK, see, my series will be filled like this. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16. This is a series of even numbers. Clear? So this is of the, which type it is? It is of the linear type. Okay. So similarly, let me select this cell. And suppose I am going to edit menu and fill series. The fill series dialog box will appear. So if I want to give the increment, I can also give the negative value also, is it no? So suppose I'm giving here 16 and I'm giving here the end value as 2 and I'm giving here the increment as minus 2. Okay, see, I have given the negative value minus 2 because I want the number from descending order. So in start value, I have given the end value, that is, as I want in descending order, I have given the biggest numbers in the start value and the lowest number in the end value. I am having the same series type as linear and I want in the down direction only. So if I click OK, see, it will be displayed like this. 16, 14, 12, 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. So this is also a series of even numbers, but it is in descending order. Clear? So next we will see the other type. Okay. So let me select this cell and let me go to the edit menu and then I have to go to the fill series. So now we have seen the linear one. Okay. So next we will move to the growth. So suppose I am having, I selected the type as series type as growth. Okay. So it will begin as a, it can be having for a multiplication table. Suppose I want to have 5, 10, 15 like that. Okay. So let me have this, generate a series of 5, 10, 15, 20 up to selected cells. Okay, the second one. So for this, what you have to do? So first I want the start value to be 5. End value, so if I am not giving the end value, it will be, the series will be filled up to the selected cells. And how my values has to be incremented? It has to be incremented by 5. 5, 10, 15, like that only I have to have. So growth, let me give it as growth, and I want in the downside only, so let me give okay. So I have not given the end value. Okay, so if I give okay, so it will be like this. So as I have not given the value, see it is performed as 525. As I have given this as growth. So as I have given growth, it is doing its multiplication. So grow, if you give in growth, it will be happened as multiplication. So if we want to have as 5, 10, 15, then in which series I have to give? I have to give in the linear series. So linear series, if I give 5 and then give here as 5, now only I will be having the series as 5, 10, 15. So linear means in addition, growth means in multiplication. So linear 5, I have not given the end value. Now let us see what happens. See? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. So I think you can see the difference. So this is the linear part. So this one is the linear and this one is the growth. Okay. So if I want to have in addition, I have to give, select the series type as linear, and if I want to have in multiplication, I have to give the series in growth. Clear? Okay. So now let me have, so if I want to have 5, 10, 15, 20 up to selected cells, I have to give it as 5, 10, 15, so up to selected cells, I have got this, right? So again, so you know how to get the even series from 2 to 20. So generate a series 2, 4, 8, 16. This is the multiplication up to 2048 they have given, okay? So up to 2048, then what should I do? So let me have this cell. Okay, let me select some cell and here let me go to edit menu and let me give the fill series. So I have to select the series. So I want to start with, what is my start value? 24816 up to 2048. So 2, start value is 2, end value is 2048. Okay, so 2048. So I want it. And then I have to give in which one? Growth. Because I want to have it as 2, 4, 8, 16 in a multiplication one. Isn't it? 2, 2s are 4, 4, 2s are 8, 8, 2s are 16. Like that. So it is multiplied with 2. So then let me give here as with 2. It must be multiplied with 2. So 2, 2s are 4, then 4, 2s are 8, 8, 16. Up to end values should be as 2048. So for multiplication, I should select the series type as growth. So I have selected as growth. So if I give OK, so see, as I selected only 2 cells, it is given as 2 and 4. So if I go on increasing my values, I will be having here as, so as I drag, it is considered as plus and I have received here. So for this, you have to select the cell. So how many cells you want, you have to select this. So let me So first, let me drag up to some cells, okay. So let me have the values to be like this. Up to 11 I am having. Now if I go to edit and I go to fill series and let me have growth and let me have 2. And here also let it be 2 and here I want 2048. So if I give OK, so I'll be having my value like this. Okay. So 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So this is what I need. 2, 4, 8, 16, 2048 up to 2048 I need it. So for this you have to select the cell and then you have to go to edit menu and then you have to go to fill series, and then in this, what you have to give? You have to go to growth, you have to select growth, and you have to click the start value as 2, and you have to give the end increment as 2, and end value should be 2048. Okay, so and if I give OK, I will receive this. Clear? Okay. So you know how to generate this seed. Next, I am giving 3330. That is, it should be decrement by up to 3. Okay, for this also, let me have select the cells. So let me select the cell, and I have to give us, so that it must start with 33, up to 3 I have to give. So let me have 33 here. Or I can go to edit menu and I can give fill series, start value is 33, end value must be 3 and it must be decremented. So I must give minus 3. As I want the series in decrement order, decreasing order, I am giving 33, start value is 33, end value is 3 and it should be incremented by minus 3. So I have given OK. So 33. 30, 27, 24, 21, 18, 15, and then 12, 9, 6, 3. So I have received the values like this. Okay. So this will be as our fill series in the descending order. Okay. And the last I have given, assume today is Friday and generate next 25 Fridays. So this belongs to date series, isn't it? No. So how we can perform the date series? So first let me give some date here. So what is the, so any day, 4-12-2020, this is the Friday. So 4-12-2020 is Friday, okay. So I want the next 25 Fridays. So let us have the next 10 Fridays, let us have, okay. Sorry. So, let me select the cell first. So, I have selected the cells. Let me have up to this, how many Fridays are coming? Let us see. Okay. So, go to edit menu and then fill series. So, now I want in the date format. So, date, day wise or month or year. So, I want in weekdays. So, I am giving weekday. So, start value. So 04-12-2020. Okay. So end value I have not given. Increment is 1. I have given as weekday. So let us see what happens. So I have selected the date and weekday and I have given the start value. This is the Friday. 4-12-2020 is Friday. Okay. So I have not given the end value. I have not, and the increment is by default it is 1. Let us see what happens. So, the date format is not correct. So, only I am receiving a number like this. So, first we have to check in which date format we are having. Okay. So, for date, if you want the date, you have to select the cell and you have to go to the edit and then you go to fill series. So, you have to select the date and then I have to, so for weekday means I have to select weekday. So, my date format is in 4. 12 and 20. Okay. And then I have to give the increment. Weekdays means I have to increment it by 7. So date, weekday, increment 7. I have not given the end value. Start value is 4-12. Okay. So if I give, okay, it will be like this. So 4, next Friday is 11, then 18. Okay. And then 25, 1, 18, 15, 22, 29, 5 to 12. So I have selected up to this. So up to selected this, these are all Fridays. Okay, so like this you can have your date. So if you want to know in which format is it, or if you want to select any format for the date, so select a cell and right click and go to format cells. So there will be an option called date. So in that you have to select by in which format you are going to give your date. So 31-12-9, that is date, format code is date, month, year. In year there is only, sorry, two numbers, isn't it? No. So that's why, okay. So that's why I have given 4-4-12-20. First I have, as I have given 20-20, I have received a wrong answer, isn't it? No. I think you have noted that. So if you want to, before giving the date values, you must be very clear. The date is In which format is that? You have format code for the date. You have to be confident about that. Then only you can give your date value. So now you know to generate the fill series for even numbers. So up to selected cells, up to a particular value, and then in decrement order, and then in the, in which one? Date format also. So for date series, you must be very clear in which format code the date you have to give. Right? So today we have seen the autofill format and autofill series. So there are four type, linear type for addition, that is the 2 plus 4 plus, if your series goes in addition, you have to take the series type as linear, and if your series goes in multiplication, you have to select the series type as growth, and if you are going to have date, then you must select that date, then only this 4 will be get enabled. And there is another option called autofill. So what it will happen? So if I select the particular cells, so and I go to edit menu and I have fill series. So if I click auto fill, all others will be disabled, including end value and increment is disabled. See here, end value is disabled and increment is also disabled. Auto fill is similarly like giving only the, like click and drag. Okay, so let me give as 1001 and it is in auto fill, so downwards. So if I give okay, sorry, this is the date format I think. 1 minute. So because as I have set it this for formatting cells, I show this as date. So that's why it's showing me. Okay. So let me click. அது ஏன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டேட்ல வந்துச்சுன்னு புரிஞ்சுதா ஏன்னா அதை கிளிக் பண்ணி உங்களுக்கு ஃபார்மட் செல்ஸ்ல 1 மினிட் ஸோ இதை கிளிக் பண்ணும் போது ஃபார்மட் செல்ஸ்ல போய் நான் உங்களுக்கு டேட் செட் பண்ணி காமிச்சேன் அதனால அது எல்லாமே டேட்ல வந்துச்சு ஓகேயா So now I am selecting another set of cells and if I go to edit and go to fill series and if I give autofill end value increment it will be become disabled. So in start value if I give 1001 and if I give OK my values will be autofill. It is similarly to setting a value and click and drag. It's similarly like that. So this is called autofill. So if you give autofill the increment value and the end value will be disabled. Clear? So this is the 4 series type. So if you click autofill, end value and increment will be disabled. So it is similar to giving a number and click and drag option autofill. So other 3 uses we have seen. So we have seen the autofill and what are all the options available in the fill series dialog box we have seen. Okay, so start value, end value, time unit, and then what are all the types, linear, growth, date and autofill. So similarly, you can, if you want a particular series of number, then you can type a number and you can use the drag fill handle and if you click and drag, you will get your number. Okay, so today we have seen about the auto fill features. So students, I think you are very clear about this. So if you have system in your home, try to do this self-practice that has been given for you in your book. Okay, thank you students.